Hey everyone, it's Kat and I'm back today to do a lipstick wear test and review. Oh, and I've got a...
Hello.
Today I'm doing a first impressions application wear test and review of the new NARS lipstick formula. Now, I historically really love NARS lipsticks, so I really wanted to try this formula. These are pretty pricey. In Australia, they're $66. You get them at Mecca. Very limited stock in store. Like, there was probably only 8 shades to choose from, whereas there's 28 on the Mecca website. On the NARS website, there's 36 shades. So it is a huge shade range, but they don't have the shade range everywhere. In the US, these are $40. And then you can buy refills, which is one benefit of this packaging. The refills are $24. Now, I don't believe the refills are in Australia, which defeats the purpose of having the refills because we can't even order from the NARS website. But apparently you can take these out. I don't know how. There we go. You can take them out and refill them, which is really good because this packaging is metal. It's quite heavy duty and it's got a really nice magnetic closure to it as well. So it's nice that they're not just putting that in landfill. But these are called the Explicit Lipsticks. So the claims of this lipstick, it's saying that it's a satin finish, vibrant, pure color payoff, creamy, smudge resistant. It's got a new precision tip bullet that defines and contours for sculpted sophistication. Also contains a luxe comfort complex that hugs the lips for lightweight, medium to full coverage, infused with smoothing rosehip seed oil and hyaluronic acid to lock in moisture. So the shade that I picked up is Take It Off. This is described as a maple red. I really liked it because it gave me that blood red vibe, and I kind of like blood red lips. This isn't the most opaque, like it's a very smooth and even, but it doesn't have any white pigment to it. This range in general, so I was very limited. There weren't many shades available when I went in store yesterday, but it's very, very nude heavy. A lot of sort of burnt nudes, a lot of light nudes, a lot of brownie nudes, a lot of reddy nudes. There's very, very few bright colors. I love a bright lip, so this was sort of limiting for me, but it's very sort of true to NARS. So if you like NARS lipstick shade range in general, you'll find something that you like from this because it's a very, very typical NARS. So today I'm going to show you how this applies. I'm going to do a wear test and then I'm going to let you know how I feel about it. I might even compare it to some of their past lipstick formulations at the very end, but we'll see if this is worth the money. So it's around 9:15 in the morning. I'm going to apply this and we're going to see how it wears. I really love the shape of this bullet. It's very, very precise at the tip, so you can probably get a nice crisp line if that's something that you're interested in. Beautiful. So it's very comfortable. It's quite a thin formula. It's not like opaque in one swipe. In fact, this shade in particular, I wouldn't call opaque at all. There's a little bit of transparency to it, which I like. Almost looks like a orangey blood red stain, which is why I wanted this shade. It feels like, it looks quite shiny now, but I think it's going to settle down a little bit more. Very, very thin. It's not at all sort of, feels like a lip balm rather than like a creamy sort of thicker lipstick. Like I think of sort of old MAC matte lipsticks and they sort of feel quite thick on the lips. This is very thin, very comfortable, almost got like a bit of a slip to it. But it's nice and even and it covers the lips beautifully. No tugging, no issues, but we'll see how it wears. So you might be able to see a little bit of lip texture underneath just because it's not, it doesn't have that white pigment to it, but very even. All right, we're over an hour and a half in and I haven't eaten or had any drinks, so nothing has disrupted the lips whatsoever. It has settled down to more of a satin finish, so it doesn't have that high shine. It's still very comfortable, almost like I've got a balm that's starting to wear off. So that's the sort of feel of it. All right, this is around the 3 hour mark. I've just had lunch and a coffee and I tried to avoid like the food getting on my lips and breaking down the lipstick. So I was actually pretty careful. I was eating like really carefully and I haven't had a look in the mirror, but from what I can see in the viewfinder, this is not looking budge-proof and all that good. Like, it's fine. It's definitely not long wear, in my opinion. This is pretty standard for, like, a comfortable lipstick. This being a sort of more reddy tone, like it's obviously going to last longer than a nude, but I was expecting a bit more. So what we can see is a bit of smearing, which I'm just going to tidy up, and then a lot of wear happening around the side of the mouth, and it just sort of overall looking a little bit sheerer on the inner part, and then almost looks like I've got a lip line going on just the top and the bottom. All right, it's been 6 hours and there's been snacks and tea and stuff and water drunk and whatnot, and it's like an interesting turn of events. This actually looks like an orange stain. So this looks like it's left my lip stained, which I don't think it actually has, but that's the effect that it gives. All the sort of moisture has worn off, so I feel like I now want to reach for a lip balm. I like this color. I think the transition from like the dark sort of blood red, orangey color down to this sort of like stain orange is really pretty. I like that. I think that's a really good trait of this, but I wouldn't consider this long lasting. There's only slight bits of unevenness, but it has worn down pretty nicely. This is my normal lip texture, so I'm starting to feel like I want to reach for a lip balm, which I will do now. I have my Laneige lip sleeping mask next to me. I'm going to put this on. I'm going to wear this for another hour or so, and then I might even reapply. We'll see how we go. But I am feeling dry. Normally I wouldn't do this. I'd just let it go. But knowing that it's not going to last all day, like this is sort of halfway through a long wear test for me, there's no point really trying to like keep the integrity of the original lipstick. Like it's obviously almost gone. Still really pretty. And admittedly, I like this look as much as I liked when I originally put it on. I think this sort of like blotted down, glossy, sort of apricot-y sort of color is really, really pretty. And it makes me think that you could easily like blot this to get more of a sort of sheerer effect. And it still looks even. It still looks lovely. Okay, so it's a couple days after I last checked in. Now, after less than an hour, the color had worn down. And I sort of expected that because lip balm sort of breaks down pigment, and as soon as the lip balm wears off, so does the lipstick. So I didn't bother checking back in. I did wear this yesterday because I sort of wanted to really get my thoughts together about it. I put this on in the afternoon. I put it on quite lightly, so I sort of blotted it down a little bit. And I was quite surprised to see that when I went to have a shower and take off my makeup at night, it was still on. It was on very, very subtly, but it was still on. So it was probably on for a good 6 hours maybe. I just don't think that this wears boldly for a long time. I think it starts to wear down fairly quickly, but that sort of faded down effect does last quite a few hours. So it could easily be 6, 7, if you're lucky, maybe 8 hours. The vivid pigment and the like medium to high coverage, that does not last very long. It's definitely not budge proof or transfer proof. I know that that was one of the claims as well. This does not set down to one of those sort of lipsticks that if you kiss your hand, it's not going to transfer. You'll find this on your cups. You'll find it transferring throughout the day. If you're eating something big, you might find it sort of smearing on your chin. So it does transfer, but at the same time, it's very hard to find a sort of comfortable, glossy, lightweight, sort of lip nourishing formula that doesn't transfer. Kind of annoys me that these days lipsticks feel like they need to have these sort of long wear bold claims as well as these sort of contradictory claims, just, I don't know, so they stand up against other lipsticks in the market. I'm not too sure. My experience trying hundreds of different lipstick formulas, I feel like you can have one, you can't often have the other. There are lipsticks that sort of skirt the middle ground. I would say that this is one, but long wear and sort of transfer proof should not be a claim of this. So what do I think about this lipstick? And of course, I'm just talking about this specific shade because I only have one. Firstly, I do really like the packaging. It feels very nice and weighty and good quality. This is something that I would want to refill. I feel like the packaging will hold up and look good over a long period of time. There are some refillable lipsticks that I've had and I'm like, well, this packaging doesn't wear very well. It looks sort of grubby and it looks sort of scratched and warped. So I don't really want to refill it. So this is something that I would want to refill. It feels really sturdy. I've also seen some refillable products products, and I'm looking at like Charlotte Tilbury and the powders and whatnot, that if you actually buy the refill, it's not that much cheaper than buying a new one entirely. This one, there is a decent price difference, so it is worthwhile, instead of throwing it all out, just refilling it, which I think is a really great move. My question is, are the refills actually coming to Australia, and are the refills going to come to the rest of the market where these are stocked? Because if they don't come, then it sort of defeats the purpose of the whole refillable thing. It's like, yeah, you can remove the lipstick inside, but if you can't put something else in there, why? I don't know why. So hopefully they do come to Australia. So for $66, I am not personally blown away by this lipstick. I'm not saying you have to like run, don't walk, go get them before they sell out. Like, no, that's not the case. I think this is a good lipstick, but I don't think I'm going to be running out to the shops and buying multiples in this formula, because it's just, it's good, but I don't think it's amazing. And I think I can find similar things at a lower price point in my collection. However, in saying that, if I found another shade that I really, really loved, I would be confident buying it. So I was thinking to myself, why did NARS bring this out besides the refillable package? And I was having a think. I don't have all NARS lip formulas, but I have quite a lot of them. And I did think that this actually fills a bit of a void in their range. And also, in my opinion, sort of goes with what is trending in makeup at the moment. So this is a lightweight, comfortable lipstick with reasonably decent pigmentation. Pigmentation, I do think, is going to vary from shade to shade. I would say mine is probably more of a medium pigmentation, because I can see my lip through it, and it's not fully opaque, but it's bold enough to make a statement. So I think this is for the people that want a really comfortable sort of nourishing feel, but with color. And I feel like what NARS has had in the past, which is what I'm going to show you, is they've either had really bold lipsticks. So these are Audacious lipsticks. These to me are a lot thicker, a lot more paint-like. These to me are a lot bolder. You can see how this is like blanks out my skin. It's very bold. But it's also quite thick on the lips. These do wear a lot better, in my opinion. So these last longer, but this is a lot more comfortable and a lot thinner. So if you are hesitant about wearing a lip because you don't like that sort of cakey feel or that matte feel, I think that's where this comes in. They're trying to give you an option that's really comfortable, that's really lightweight, that's quite nourishing, won't dry out your lips, but you get a nice bold look. I do actually have a red NARS Audacious lipstick, so I'll just show you again the difference. It is creamy, but you can see that this has a lot more shine to it, so it's got a lot more nourishing ingredients. Then of course you have my favorite NARS lip products, which are the Velvet Matte Lip Pencils. These I think are stunning, but they are a lot drier. They're very, very matte, and I'll show you this close up soon. They're a lot drier. They wear really beautifully, but they are really dry. Then there's more like liquidy options. There are some like really budge-proof matte options, which again won't be for people that want something that's very comfortable on the lips. Those are for more for like the really bold budge-proof products. I have a couple of sort of glossier options. This is the Full Vinyl Lip Lacquer. It's really bold, really shiny, but also quite like thick on the lips. Again, it's, you can tell it's there. These have been discontinued. These are Velvet Lip Glides, and these were supposed to be like a lip gloss with more of a like matte satin finish. So when you first apply them, they look quite glossy, but they settle down a little bit. Out of all things swatched on my hand, I would say that the finish and the feel is probably most similar to the Velvet Lip Glide, but it's obviously in a bullet and it does last a lot longer. These two do wear off fairly quickly. This is very sticky and thick. This is a very thick formula. It can feel quite heavy on the skin. In comparison, this is a lot thinner, as you can see. So there are, and this is a lot more matte and set. So there are differences, but I feel like this sort of bridges the gap between a few of these formulas. So all of that to pretty much say that I understand why they're going in this direction. If I was to recommend this to anyone, I would say that if you're the type of person that wants a nice amount of color on your lips, a comfortable formula, nothing too matte, nothing too sort of glossy and transfer-y and too shiny, and you want to feel like it's sort of like a lip balm rather than a heavy lipstick, I would say try this. This is the kind of lipstick that I would recommend to someone who is having a special occasion. They might be trying to find their wedding color. They might be, you know, trying to mark a special event by getting a lipstick that they really enjoy. What I think is probably the best factor about this for me is how nicely it wears down. I really have issues with lipsticks. They might look nice and bold and they might stay bold for a long time, but then they start to like flake off or they start to look really patchy and it looks unfinished. That irritates me to no end. So if this starts to fade down, but it fades down evenly and it almost looks like just a sheerer lip color, I'm all for that. I would wear this to an event where I know that I'm eating and I'm drinking and it is fading down, but I'm like, it still looks like a put together beautiful lipstick that's comfortable. So I get it. I think it's lovely, but at the same time, I do think you can get similar concepts at a lower price point. So I'd be singing this praise more if it was a bit cheaper. So if you've tried these lipsticks, I'd love to know what you think in the comments. I have heard quite a few comments from people saying that these don't wear as well as the Audacious ones, so what's the point? I do agree with that. I think the Audacious ones do last longer, but I also think they feel a lot more sort of like suffocating on the lips and a little bit more like you've got a layer of sort of like paint rather than a lip gloss. And comfort-wise, I think these totally surpass the Audacious lipsticks. So yes, the longevity isn't the same. The pigmentation isn't the same either, but it just really depends on what you value in a lip product. So thank you so much for watching. A big thank you to my members for supporting my channel, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye. Hello everyone, it's Kat and I'm back today to, whenever I say this, I get a kid pop up on my shoulder.
Hello.
Hello, can you say hello?
Hello.
Who do you see? Who do you see?
Mum.
Mum, and who else? Finn. How was your
truck?
You saw the rubbish trucks?
Yes.
Yes, excellent. Who's that?
Mama.
And who else?
Finn.
Finn.